all the words I know, there's no word that makes many of my colleagues more emotional and prone to foam at the mouth than the one I'm just about to say. Consciousness. A lot of scientists dismiss this as complete BS and totally irrelevant, and then a lot of others think this is like the central thing. I have to worry about machines getting conscious and so on. What do I think? I think consciousness is both irrelevant and incredibly important. Let me explain why. First of all, if you are chased by a heat-seeking missile, it's completely irrelevant to you whether this heat-seeking missile is conscious, whether it's having a subjective experience, whether it feels like anything to be that heat-seeking missile. Because all you care about is what the heat-seeking missile does, not how it feels. And that shows that it's a complete red herring to think that you're safe from future AI if it's not conscious. It's the behavior that you want to make sure is aligned with your goals. On the other hand, there is a way in which consciousness is incredibly important, I feel. And there's also a way in which it's absolutely fascinating. If we rewind 400 years or so, you know, Galileo, he could have told you that if you throw an apple and a hazelnut, they're going to move exactly in this shape of a parabola, and he can give you all the math for it, but he would have no clue why the apple was red and the hazelnut was brown, or why the apple was soft and the hazelnut was hard. That seemed to him beyond science. And science back 400 years ago could only really say sensible things about this very limited domain of phenomena to do with motion. Then came the Maxwell equations and told us all about light and colors, and that became within the realm of science. Then we got quantum mechanics that told us why the apple is softer than the hazelnut, and all other properties of matter. And science has gradually conquered more and more of the natural phenomena. And if you ask now what science can do, it's actually a lot faster to describe what little it is that science cannot talk about sensibly. And I think the final frontier actually is consciousness. People mean a lot of different things by that word. I simply mean subjective experience. The experience of colors, sounds, emotions, and so on, that it feels like something to be me, which is quite separate from my behavior, which I could have even if I were a zombie and didn't experience anything at all, potentially. So why should you care about that? I care about it, first of all, because fundamentally, that's the basic thing I know about the world, my experiences, and I would love to understand scientifically why that is, and not just leave it to philosophers. And second, it's incredibly important also in terms of purpose and meaning. In the laws of physics, there is nothing about meaning. There's no equation for it. And I feel that we shouldn't look for our universe to give meaning to us, because it's us who give meaning to our universe, because we are conscious and experiencing things, right? Our universe didn't used to be conscious. It used to be just a bunch of stuff moving around. And gradually, these incredibly complicated patterns got arranged into our brains. And we woke up, and now our universe is aware of itself. We have galaxies out there. They're incredibly beautiful. Why are they beautiful? Because we are consciously aware of them. We see them in our telescopes. If in the future we screw up with technology and all life goes extinct, then our universe will go back to being meaningless and just a giant waste of space, as far as I'm concerned. And when a colleague tells me that they think consciousness is BS, I challenge them to tell me what is wrong with rape and torture, and to explain that to me without using the word consciousness or the word experience. Because if they can't talk about that, it's just that the whole thing that they are saying is so bad is just a bunch of electrons and quarks moving around in some particular way rather than some other particular way. And what's so bad about that? I feel the only way we can actually have any logical scientific foundation of ethics, morality, purpose, and meaning is precisely in terms of experience, in terms of consciousness. And this makes it really important as we prepare for our future to understand what this is. And I, for one, think that this is actually something that we can also ultimately understand scientifically. I don't think that the difference between a living bug and a dead bug is that the living bug has some sort of secret life source in it. I think of the bugs as mechanisms, and the dead bug is just a broken mechanism. Similarly, I think that what makes my brain conscious, but the food I ate, which got rearranged into my brain, wasn't conscious, isn't because they're made of different kind of stuff. It's the same quarks rearranged, right? It's the pattern into which they're arranged. And I think it's a scientific question. What properties does this pattern of information processing have for there to be a subjective experience there? You could imagine building a brain scanner. Actually, we have pretty good ones at MIT where I work, and having some software in it which tests out whatever theory you have for consciousness and makes predictions for what you experience. And if I'm sitting in this machine and the computer screen tells me, okay, right now I see information processing in your brain indicating that you are consciously aware of the thought of an apple. And I'm like, yeah, that's right. I click correct. And then it says, I see information about your heartbeat in your brain when you're aware of this. And I'm like, no, I was not conscious of that. Now I've ruled out the theory that was implemented in this software. So it's falsifiable. That means it was a scientific theory, right? If we can one day find a theory like this, and there are some candidates on the market, like Giulio Tononi's integrated information theory, for example, if we ever find any theory that keeps passing tests like that and we start taking it seriously, and we can use it to build a consciousness detector, that's first of all going to be really useful. Physicians in the emergency room would love it if they get an unresponsive patient coming in, put them in the consciousness scanner, and figure out whether they have locked-in syndrome and just can't communicate, but they're conscious, or whether there's nobody home. And this will also let us understand whether future AI systems we build are conscious and whether we should feel guilty or not about switching them off. Some people might prefer that their future home helper robot is an unconscious zombie, so they don't have to feel guilty about giving it boring chores or powering it down. Some people might prefer that it's conscious, so that there can be a positive experience in there, and so that they don't feel creeped out by this machine just faking it, you know, and pretending to be conscious, even though it's a zombie. And most importantly, in the longer term future, if far from now we have life that's spread out from Earth to other galaxies, and the whole cosmos is alive and doing amazing things. And although if this life becomes the descendants of humanity, wouldn't it suck if it turns out that this is all just zombies with no consciousness, and the whole thing that we felt so good about before we passed away was just a play for empty benches? I feel that we should really, really tackle this final frontier of scientific ignorance, the problem of consciousness, and get this stuff figured out so we can shape a future which is truly awesome, not just kind of from the outside that cool stuff seems to be happening, but that there's actually someone home to experience all this.